Welcome to Launching the Pilot with your hosts, Brian and Paul.
Welcome to Launching the Pilot, episode 200.
Season.
Hey. Did you ever think we'd make it this far?
No.
Past episode 10. No.
That's one was looking iffy.
Yeah.
Barbara Bain.
Barbara Bain, the saviour.
Not like her husband.
She's got three Emmys. He's only got an Oscar.
One Oscar, we've discussed this, is worth three Emmys.
It's easily not. She won three consecutive Emmys for in a row.
He won one consecutive Oscar.
From Space 1999.
No. That doesn't matter. He knew, didn't want to tread on her toes, you know, oh, let the little woman with it.
I wonder what those together were at the most shelf space. Do you think the Oscars?
Yeah. They had a pedestal. Down a long corridor.
Use the Emmys to stand on to polish it.
Yeah, yeah. Down a long corridor on a bright pedestal of its own.
Well, I thought for the 200th we'd do something
special
that many, many people have done before.
So you say.
But it was supposed to launch a load of these episodes.
This was
just going to be a one-off.
I'm glad it was. and it's topical at this moment in time.
It is.
Maybe a couple of weeks out.
By the time this one goes out, it will be. But this is...
Good, we can spoil that one later as well.
Well, we can, spoil away. And this is the Star Wars Holiday Special 1978.
Oh, yes. One episode.
The CBS special.
Came out 78, I think.
It did, 78, yeah. That's what you said, 78.
One season.
278. And now this has got the proper cast.
Oh,
Star Wars, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes. And despite what your listener says, I had never ever seen this before.
Or heard of it. You'd never heard of it.
I'd never ever heard of it.
I can't remember when I heard of it. I was young though, I knew its existence.
And that's what sent you twisted.
Yeah. I mean, but it's really hard to get hold of in this country.
Well, yeah, I mean, YouTube, whether YouTube, I want to go to this.
But... No, and that's the thing, isn't it? Now we've got a digital media.
Yeah, I mean, and it's still not on... I search my Star Wars Blu-ray discs. It's not on any of them.
If you have the original saga ones, which I think you do, don't you? I think there's the cartoons, actually, as a special feature.
Oh, the original DVD ones?
No, the Blu-rays.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
With Anakin on the cover, is it?
Yes. Yeah.
I think somewhere there's a special.
Oh, is it? Oh.
And the cartoon is included. Despite George Lucas saying all the masters are gone now.
Yeah.
They must have got that source from somewhere.
Well, him.
Yeah.
Because he owns the DVD. Because he gets all the rights for everything. And nothing goes on the Blu-rays without him saying.
I would imagine so.
Yeah, you can put that in.
And also... is the Empire of Dreams, a documentary about Star Wars, and that was on the original DVDs I brought of Star Wars, and it was going to include footage from this holiday special.
Oh.
And he gave permission for him to use it, but it was never used.
I wonder why.
Cutting room floor. So we got Harrison Ford as Han Solo.
We have
Carrie Fisher as
alive.
Princess Leia.
Alive!
She was at the time, yeah. Well remembered. We have Mark Hamill.
Looking
quite weird.
Yes. Possibly. I'm not quite sure. Some sort of makeup malfunction there going on.
Well, he'd had that terrible car crash that was almost fatal. It wasn't quite fatal because he's still here.
No, that's true.
And so they just plastered the makeup on him to cover it over. Because that's why, I think in Empire, he starts off in the tank and all this, and he gets hit by the Yeti, whatever it's called.
Oh, yeah, but the listener will know,
yeah,
the thing.
Taunton.
The thing in the ice.
I'll just say the wrong thing. Yeah. Oh, Taunton hits him.
Oh, they never know.
There was no way he was going to survive that cold inside of Taunton.
No, I know.
But he didn't, because If you look, you can see Han Solo setting up a tent. Sorry, this is one of the pee things I have. Han Solo was setting up a tent for them. Now, I don't know if he pulled Luke into the tent once he'd set it up.
Yeah, that's in your dream again, isn't it? Come here, little boy.
And a small shower. Anyway.
Let me warm you up.
And we have Anthony Daniels as C-3PO.
We do.
But we do not get Kenny Baker as R2-D2.
No, I did notice that.
Yeah, it was very clear, wasn't it?
Yeah, it wasn't Kenny.
R2-D2 played R2-D2.
He used to live round here.
He did.
We used to see him a lot.
He did. He used to go to the pictures and stuff.
Yeah, we used to see him a lot round here. That was our claim to fame.
Yeah, and it's got James L. Jones as the voice of Darth Vader, but I think he was just taken out of the movie. Cut.
Yeah, I think it was as well. Yeah, I have made note of that. Yeah. I think it's the original Chewie as well.
It is the original Chewie. Peter Mayhew.
Yeah.
It is as Chewie.
Yes.
The Star Wars Holiday Special. Starring Mark Hamill as Luke Skywalker. Harrison Ford as Han Solo. Carrie Fisher as Princess Leia. With Anthony Daniels as C-3PO. Peter Mayhew as Chewbacca. R2-D2 as R2-D2. And James Earl Jones as the voice of Darth Vader. Introducing Chewbacca's family. His wife, Mala. His father, Itchy. His son, Lumpy. With special guest stars, Beatrice Arthur, Art Carney, Diane Carroll, the Jefferson Starship, Harvey Korman, and an animated Star Wars story on the Star Wars Holiday Special.
Anyway,
yes.
Shall we start? I don't really want to, but shall we start?
Well, let's start. Let's get this ball going, yeah? So I've got the Falcon is being pursued by two Star Destroyers.
They are. Han and Chewie at the controls.
And film footage.
This look a bit small, this cockpit.
That's it. I'm turning back. I know your family's waiting.
I know it's an important day.
All right, we'll give it a try.
I'll set your coordinates.
Won't jump far. I'll get you back there in time, pal. Trust me. Our only hope now is I'll run that Imperial garbage scow, though. I'm going to lightspeed.
That's the spirit. You'll be celebrating Life Day before you know it.
Stand by. Here's where I say goodbye to our unpleasant friends.
Yes.
It did, didn't it?
Yeah.
I can't work out...
I've got a lot of film footage coming up.
I couldn't work out if they were in the actual set and it was just filmed odd, or they'd built a new set. Because there's no way you'd get four people in there.
No.
They weren't actually shoulder to shoulder.
Yeah. I can hope. Maybe it was a prototype. Well, I don't know.
I think it's some sort of mock-up.
I don't know. I'm not quite sure because everything else seemed...
Legit.
So I'm not sure... Someone out there will probably.
Yeah, I'm sure there is.
Whether it was just built just for this, or it's built for close up scenes in the proper film, or. But as you say, yeah, they're very close.
Yeah. I must admit, I watched this and I thought I'd look up some facts and things and get all this info. But I felt dirty after watching it and I couldn't go into it.
Because I can't remember, does he have his dice?
I don't even remember them being in it.
No, I don't think the dice are hanging up, are they, in this?
But the dice aren't important, are they? Or until you get to Last Jedi, or...
Well, it's a major prop.
Solo.
Yeah.
Have you seen Solo?
I have seen Solo.
Did you watch it by yourself? Because you have to watch it solo.
Well, obviously.
That's what it says on the poster today.
Well, yeah.
And I was the only one in the cinema, so I really took it in the heart.
You're nothing if not professional. Yeah. Stick by the rules. It says solo, you go solo.
I quite enjoyed solo.
Yeah, not enough shower scenes. Yeah.
Well, I'd like Chewbacca to have at least a couple. He needed it off that mud. But, as you say, they're being pursued.
Yeah,
Han wants to turn back. He says, I'm sorry, what can we do?
Yeah, I've got Chewie's not happy.
He's not.
He wants to go home for life day.
Life day, it is indeed.
Life day, and Han is saying, I'm really, really sorry.
I know it's an important day, but...
I get that. You know, I've never let you down. It's Chewie. And there's a lot of that.
Yeah.
Could perfect this by then.
That was just me watching it.
He says, I'll do my best. I'll get you there.
Yeah.
Big fella.
And then they jump to light speed, don't they?
Yeah.
And then...
We've got a classic opening.
Classic opening, it is.
Yeah.
I like these old type openings where they introduce each person. You know, is Mark Hamill as Luke Skywalker.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Be Arthur. I don't know. Canteen wench.
But it's got. I've got all the stars.
Yeah.
And then it's coming up. And then Jefferson Starship. And I'm like,
and you're thinking, why aren't they top billing? Nothing's going to stop them now.
And I was intrigued now. But how the hell are you going to get Jefferson Starship into this one?
They got the right name.
Well, that's the only reason I can possibly think they were in this.
UFO weren't big enough, or I don't know.
Because they even dropped the Jefferson after a while and just became Starship.
Didn't they? Yeah.
Perhaps they disassociated himself after watching this.
No, that wasn't us. That was a different Jefferson. So we'll get introduced to Chewie's family.
Yeah, Chewie's family. Now, I got confused with the names because they all look the same.
I've got Marla.
Marla.
Marla is the wife.
Yeah. Grandfather.
Itchy.
Now, is Itchy the grandfather?
No, he's Chewie's dad.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, Itchy's Chewie's dad. Then Lumpy.
With the son.
Lumpy, yeah.
Yeah, Lumpy.
Lumpy was the son.
Yeah, I couldn't work out Lumpy. They look the same. I couldn't work out who was who after a while.
Well, their grandpa was old and white, he had a cane.
Yeah, I know.
Son was little. Yeah.
But it was the name. Which one was Lumpy? I couldn't work it out.
Which one's Scratchy? Yeah. You've got to have Itchy and Scratchy.
And luckily, it was sponsored by GM Motors.
It was. I've got that. They didn't disassociate themselves with it.
Yeah.
But you think they'd put another car name on there?
Yeah, yeah.
Honda.
Ford.
Yeah.
Or GM, I think it's Ford nowadays. But
Ferrari.
Yeah. Anything but. Now, it's a bit cartoon style. Chewie's house is a bit of a cartoon to start with, isn't it?
You mean that lovely backdrop?
Yeah, cartoon.
which look like a cartoon.
Which look like a cartoon
now,
backdrop.
Now, I know the Wookiee homeworld is called Kesh, I think.
Maybe. I'm not sure your pronunciation.
I'm not sure of my pronunciation.
I won't argue with you.
I've written it down here, but there's far too many Y's in it, surely.
Oh, who knows?
Right, I've got
Lumpy's playing.
Yeah. I've got Itchy's building an X-Wing out of wood. He looks like he's carving one.
Yes.
The son's already playing with one. I'm not sure why he'd want two.
No.
You've built a TIE fighter.
Yeah.
So it's a fight against.
Yeah.
Our mum's doing housework.
Yeah. Well, I've got your... Gramps isn't happy.
Yeah.
Because he's moaning. And
the son's all around him and the grandson.
And mum's not happy. And then I've got him bracket. She's a looker.
Yeah, she is.
She's you got to go for it. You go, I'll go for it.
I'm not 100% sure.
Well, I wasn't sure, but go for it. She could be.
A woman.
You said it, sir.
Well, I'm not sure what distinguishes the fact, apart from the penny.
I think it was played by a guy anyway, but...
I wouldn't know.
Because obviously the height.
Oh, yeah, could be.
There's not that many tall women, yeah.
No. And Lumpy sort of moans to him.
Is that
Lumpy, the kid.
The kid, yeah, he moans. Because the grandfather's moaning at him, then he goes to get take to eat, and the mum moans at
So he
Lumpy.
Goes outside, doesn't he? And he's balancing along the edge
It's walking on the rail, isn't
rails,
he?
Yeah.
And they're like a thousand,
a mile, yeah.
100 billion feet in the air.
Yeah, it's a big tree.
Like looking at the drawing.
It was a big tree.
It was a big tree.
Yeah. But he's all right, he's fine.
But the thing is, they're talking to each other.
I know.
But there's no subtitles.
No.
It's all in Wookiee-ese.
But But some of the Wookiees is like, because she says it at one point, like, they're washing up.
Yeah.
I've not heard this, surely.
It's like me on New Year's Day. Yeah. Like,
they're washing up. No. I'm bored. Yeah. Washing up.
Oh, yeah. It is, isn't it? It's like Goonies, isn't it?
Yes. Yeah. But in Wookiee style.
Yeah.
Because they say, there is no subtitles.
Nothing.
There is nothing. And I'm thinking, oh, perhaps I've missed this. Perhaps I've missed the subtitles. No.
There was never any subtitles.
No. And you're thinking,
thank you,
really?
George Lucas.
What's going on here? But yeah, so he don't want to do.
I put it's a long way painted down.
Yeah.
When the boys climbed all over the rail.
Now, Gramps.
Richie, yeah.
He calls over Lumpy, doesn't he?
Yeah.
He says, come on, we're going to watch some... Now, I've got... Gramps wants to watch some porn. Because when it came on, and I'm thinking, hold on a minute.
Well, I've got... It's a dancing girl. Oh, no, it's not.
Well, it's a... Obviously, Gramps likes his people shaved. Because these were normal people.
It's a fetish.
Yeah. But I'm thinking, they ain't got much on. You shaved the boy.
But these are acrobats.
Yeah, but I still thought...
This is like Circus the Sleigh.
Yeah. It's like, come on. You should watch this, son. Yeah. Don't worry about your mother.
Yeah. But Lumpy loves it.
I bet he did and all.
That's why it's called Lumpy, aren't they?
And then I'm sitting there thinking... This is a holiday special. This is on at Christmas. What's going on here?
It gets worse.
Oh, no, it gets worse.
And there's one button he presses and it makes the lead jester...
I don't know. Yeah.
Bigger. And then he's inviting all the other ones onto table.
I've got Itchy's happy. And I'm like, why wouldn't he be? Because he's watching.
He gives a little clap.
But yes, yeah, they're
that's all, folks, so it must have ended. Just like, yeah. I haven't written any notes about what they did. There was juggling. It was all standard stuff for acrobats.
Yeah, but it's done on their micro. I don't know what they are. It's almost like when they're playing that chess game, isn't it?
Yeah, it's the same sort of table as the chess game.
It's the chess board on the Millennium Falcon.
Yeah.
And only this is normal people doing... Just Cirque du Soleil. Yeah, they're just...
There's a bit of juggling, tumbling.
Isn't there a clown? I can't remember.
There could have been.
Yeah. I think that was the ones watching it.
Now, Lumpy has to get back to work to do his chores.
Yeah. Now, I've got
Mala tries to make a call. She may be trying to make a call. It might not be a call.
So, Itchy needs to do Luke with R2 and makeup. I can't remember what. Oh yeah, because Luke.
She calls Luke.
Yeah.
And he goes, what's wrong, Mala?
Yeah.
He goes, let me speak to Chewie.
Yeah.
He doesn't understand Wookiee.
No, but R2 does.
R2 does, but they're trying to fix an engine.
Yeah, in a shed?
In a shed. Very much like our podcast studio.
Now, this is supposed to be after the first film.
Yes.
So they've destroyed the Death Star. You know, everyone's happy.
Yeah.
They've destroyed the Death Star. Yeah, it's pretty good. I think we could do better than a shed. Because, you know, supposedly, the... not the Alliance. They're finished. They're dead. They've destroyed the Death Star. We know they are still spread across the universe.
They've destroyed a major power hub of them. Yeah.
And I think they can celebrate. But apparently, no. Luke, you're in a shed with R2.
What's that medal get you? Nothing.
Nothing, yeah. As they told you as you were walking up.
Yeah. We all know what they said.
Yeah, we all know what they said as they were walking up. Filmed quite close to here as well.
It was.
Filmed very close to here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's a tiny little... And he's fixing an engine.
Yes.
Which is the tiniest engine. I think it might have been a Dyson.
But it's not going well anyway.
No, it's lots of smoke.
Yeah, Luke's got an awful lot of arse.
But he wants to talk to Chewie, and they say... Yeah. And they're showing a picture of Chewie, and he gets the drift that, oh, Chewie hasn't arrived yet. Oh, don't worry, Chewie and Han, they left here on time.
Yeah.
They'll get there, you know.
Yeah.
They're reliable.
Yeah, it's no problem. Now we've got shop.
He says to the mother, give me a smile, Luke does, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Why don't you smile for me?
How did we know?
I don't know.
How did we know?
I think that was a smile.
Yeah.
God.
Don't worry, look. It's Chewbacca's family. Here, keep working on it. Hello, Mala. Did she? Hiya, love me. Where's Chewbacca? Whoa, wait a minute, one at a time. Chewbacca? Yeah, well, bring him to the screen, I want to say hello to him. You don't know where he is? Oh, he's not there yet, is that it? Oh, boy. Well, all I can tell you is that he and Han left here on schedule. If he's not there now, they're way overdue.
Must have
been trouble.
Now it cuts.
I've got Lukey smoking heavily.
Yeah, I think he needed to.
Yeah, I think they all should have been.
But cutscene, we're at a shop.
Yeah, I thought, oh, is this like another thing? But she's actually calling into the shop to place an order or something.
Yes.
But then it goes to the shop.
Yes.
And there's an Imperial guard.
There's an Imperial guard there, yeah.
And then the shop says, we've got everything for you. Everything good. Possibly human or Wookiee could want.
Yes. Because obviously this shop is on the planet Wookiee.
Wookiee planet. And he says, look, I've got a pocket-sized aquarium.
Yeah, I know. Now, where? First, have you ever seen a stormtrooper Imperial guard with a pocket?
Well, they've got lots of pockets, they have utility belts, don't they?
Yeah, we're going to talk about this later. Yeah, pocket-sized aquarium.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't you?
Yeah, of course. And the Imperial Guard's not interested.
No, not interested.
But then he picks up, what's this, a Wookiee brush. I guess not just a brush, it's Ronco's. other things in one.
Yeah.
And he says, oh, I'll take that. He goes, oh, will you be bartering for it? Or will it be Imperial coin? He goes, no, I'll just take it.
Yeah, I'm just going to take it. Now, he's not the greatest actor, is he, this Imperial guard?
No, he's not.
No, that's big fair.
His moustache is doing more acting than he is.
Yeah. Well, let's face it, he was probably going to be stationed on the Death Star this week, and now that's down, and now he's
and
like...
He had all his stuff already moved to the Death Star.
Oh, I've lost God. A lot, yeah.
My pocket aquarium.
That's gone, yeah. Now, this is where Marla, the shopkeeper takes the message, doesn't he?
Yes.
Because he says...
It's a bit coded, isn't it?
Yeah, I got that. Right. Shaggy carpet is on its way.
Meaning Chewie.
It took me a while.
I had to read that.
I got the Enigma machine to work it out for me. I went up to Bletchley.
I just owned Benedict Cumberbatch. You were in that film, weren't you?
No, see, we've got a free pass, so I went up. Got that going on it.
Bletchley Park, yeah.
And it worked, not far from here. That worked.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's what it came out with.
Yeah.
It means Chewie.
Chewie's on his way.
Yeah.
Got a wall screen custom. Good to see you again. Don't say a word, madam. I know just why you're calling. You're wondering when that shaggy carpet you ordered will arrive at your home. Let me assure you, madam, it's on its way. You know, it was made especially for you by a little old woman four planets away. She did it all by herself. In fact, you might say she did it by hand. Solo. Though it's going to take some time to get to you. I know you understand. Understand, don't you? Terrific. By the way, I'll be by later to drop off that extra photon energy pack. You're welcome.
Oh, that's what I forgot. The Imperial Guard, going back to him, has got an incredibly deep voice.
He has. Some say it's a really boring voice, Ted. Yeah.
But,
he has obviously only done porn before.
Yes.
This first time.
Well, Litchi would be happy about that. Yeah. I'm sure he's probably got his autograph. But anyway. But yeah. Shaggy Carpy's on his way. I got coded message badly.
Then we've got Darth Vader.
Stock footage of Darth Vader.
You think so?
Oh, possibly. See him as he's walking down the corridor. Yeah.
We just dubbed this over. We're looking for the rebels.
Yeah, that's
the expand what the search. That was it.
That was it, right? Yeah. Which wasn't in the original film. Yeah. So they just expanded that. And let's face it, I mean, do we know he's talking? Does a light come over his shoulder or something? Like the Daleks when they're talking? No.
It'd be funny if it was David Prowse's original voice, though, wouldn't it?
Oh, stand search. Come on, boys, come on. I don't know why they didn't go with my voice. Black really suits you. Don't like white, it shows the stains.
You've been watching Julie and Clary again, haven't you?
I am Julie and Clary.
We're back at the Wookiee place.
I have no idea. Oh, yeah, Mum's watching the cooking show. Oh, God, yes. Oh.
Now, to be honest...
Yeah.
I skipped a lot of this.
Did you?
I didn't. I couldn't face it.
I'm in for the pound. I'm going for me pound of flesh here.
I saw visual search. This is going nowhere.
I'm not up on these people.
All right.
But I recognised her.
Yes.
I don't know why.
Was it Art Carney?
Is it?
Yeah.
The only one I did recognise who comes a bit later, so I'll say that.
Yeah, we know who it is.
Yes. But it's Headley. Yeah, that was the... But I kind of recognised her. Now...
Her?
Yeah.
You say her?
Well...
Throw a wig on it. It's a her. Yeah. Yeah, okay.
Well, you're saying that about Marla. I mean, how do you know?
Marla was all woman, you could tell.
Yeah. Couldn't you?
Just by the smile.
Cheeky little smile. Yeah. Yes. Now... Apparently, Mum has to hack a bantha rump because she's the cooking, and she's saying, "Oh, you get your bantha, your fresh bantha, and you get the tenderloin or whatever it is." And Mum's like,
"And you dice it into pieces."
And she goes, "But if you can't afford that, you can always use rump." And, so she's got rump, and she's hacking this bantha rump apart. I've no idea. And she's got, now we put it in the bowl and we stir it.
Yes.
And now we whip it.
Bantha surprise is the dish.
Now.
I've got skip.
See, luckily I didn't.
No.
So she's stirring it, whipping it, stirring it, whipping it.
And she goes, beating it.
Cooking can be fun. Now a third arm is.
Yeah.
Yeah. And now, I can't remember what the third hand's doing. And then a fourth.
It's beating it. The third hand is beating it.
And then a fourth
whipping,
arm.
Whipping, stirring, beating. And she's about to sneeze and the fourth arm comes up.
God knows why.
Yeah. And Marla's trying to keep up with these instructions.
Yes.
But she's only got two arms.
Yeah. Handicapped. But she does her best, and then she says, now we stick it in the oven, or we put it on the boil for 15 days, or something. Oh, Christ, I can't remember. But they did something with it.
Yeah.
Now, stock footage of fighting TIE fighters.
In the Millennium Falcon.
Yeah.
I said, sorry about this, I didn't realise we'd drop straight into this, but it's better than against them Star Destroyers,
yeah.
I've got to say that, despite... obviously not want to be there, Harrison Ford is actually trying.
Yes. he's putting a bit more effort into this. Well, he's only a carpenter. What's he got full back on? You know what I mean?
But I built this set.
At least Carrie Fisher's got a mum to carry. You know what I mean? He's got nothing, has he?
No, it's true. He was in an episode of Kung Fu. Surely the residuals from that alone would have paid for a nice lifestyle.
No.
All right, okay.
All right, the coordinates weren't the best.
Out of the frying pan into the fire, huh, pal? How should I know we'd come out of hyperspace in the middle of an Imperial convoy? At least against these fighters, we've got more of a chance. However slim. Say that again. This is one life they won't soon forget. Wait, I lost control of the remote cannons.
I'm gonna have to run back and operate the aft gun manually. Stay on things here. Why do I always think that taking you home for life day is gonna be easy?
But now we've got a Empire new broadcast.
Yes.
Because the Empire...
Attention! Yeah. Yeah, martial law is decreed.
Yeah, because everyone stay in your homes.
No ships will land, no ships will take off.
Yes, and we're going to make everyone watch the cooking channel.
There's a knock at the door.
Yeah, someone's at the door. Yeah, and it's not Mr. Rogers. No, it's the shopkeeper.
It is. Suddenly the shopkeeper appears. And it's the trading post guy I've got. Yep. I think we had a name, like Saul or something. I've got it written down somewhere, but...
It
really does.
And he's bought presents.
Yes,
that's nice present. Because it's life day.
It is life day.
He knows it. He works on Wookiee land, so he might know his life day.
He doesn't even get life day off, though.
No.
You think you'd get it off.
I presume he's human. I have no clue. Shaved monkey?
It's my pedal.
Yeah. Well, so are they.
It could have been a Wookiee shaved.
He could have been.
He speaks pretty good English.
Yeah. He's better English than they do. But anyway...
Itchy gets a wow.
Gets a what?
A wow.
Does he?
Yeah.
I've got Itchy Gramps.
Yeah.
Because I think I worked it out then which one was Itchy. He's watching more dancing nymphs.
Well, I thought he got a hairdryer, but it's something that goes over his head, and then this hologram come up.
Yeah, I've got it. He's got dancing nymphs and a lady, and I've got it. Is this for kids?
Yeah. I've got Wookiee porn.
Yeah, I told you. That goes back to my early point.
But she's human, isn't she? Well,
yeah, but...
She's class.
Again, she's semi-naked.
But what she's saying is, I'm all yours.
Yeah, I know.
I'm only yours.
I want you. You can come and take me and all this. And again, I'm thinking, this is Christmas.
And Itchy Grampier, he grabs an extra cushion to cover himself.
Which turned out to be lumpy.
It was after it finished.
Itchy, I am here. My voice is for you alone. I am found in your eyes only. I exist for you. I am in your mind as you create me. Oh, yes. I can feel my creation. I'm getting your message. Are you getting mine? Oh. We are excited, aren't we? Well, just relax. Just relax. Yeah. Now, we can have a good time. I'll tell you a secret. I find you adorable.
But it's just like, this is real. This can't be.
Then we get a song.
Yes, then she starts singing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just like, in an erotic kind of way.
Yeah, very erotic kind of way. And you think, no, this isn't right.
But then, thankfully, that finishes.
Yes.
And we get Leia and C-3PO in a closet.
You've just destroyed the Death Star, for God's sake. Maybe, they know they've destroyed it and they know the Empire are going to be looking for them. So let's just hide in a closet. Luke got to the shed first, we've got to take the closet.
And they're doing the communications, aren't they? And
yeah.
Happy Life Day. And
yeah. Right.
Han and Chewie are not there yet.
No.
Because C-3PO, of course, he speaks...
Fluent Wookiee.
Fluent Wookiee, okay.
Yeah. But to be honest, Carrie Fisher, no, she's going for it.
She is.
She's going for it as well. Luke didn't put a lot of effort in, but Han and... they're going for it.
Yeah.
I have made the connection. You may speak now if you wish.
Mala, it's so good to see you. Happy Life Day.
She says it may be a happy life day for you, but personally, she's seen happier ones.
I don't want to tie up the channels. So could you do me a favor and send either Chewbacca or Han Solo to the screen, please?
She says that she would like to grant your request, but is quite unable to do so.
You mean they haven't arrived yet?
She says there has been no contact.
Yes, I think I understand her message. That Imperial Patrol must be giving them more trouble than we bargained for. Mala, are you alone?
you would permit me. No, she says she is not alone. She's with a friend.
Could he come to the screen, please?
Good afternoon, ma'am. I'm Sondan, a local traitor, a friend of the rebellion, and a member of the Alliance.
Good. Look, I know I can count on you to take care of my friends until their leader returns. You'll do that for me, won't you?
Yes, indeed, ma'am. That's what I'm here for.
She's expressing her warmth towards the traitor.
Look, I can see you're in good hands, Mala. I'll contact you again soon.
And your friend, and Lee says, "Oh, can I talk to someone else? Is there anyone else there?" And she goes, "Oh, yeah, it's the I'll talk to the shopkeeper."
Yeah, yeah, as you would.
Yeah, and so they communicate because obviously.
Yeah. And
now the Millennium Falcons has actually made it.
Yes, it's because they're going to land on the north side of the planet.
That's right.
It's far away.
Now, when you're approaching a planet, how do you know which one's the north side?
I have no idea.
Oh, okay, so have you were upside down?
Because you can't even go, well, it's the side the sun's on, because most of them have got 12.
Yeah.
12 suns and 6 moons, so I have no idea.
Maybe it's just got a big sign, North Park.
North car park, yeah. Courtesy car park, north.
The family hear it overhead.
Yes.
They know the sounds of the Falcon.
They do. In our case, it's like the bald eagle. But
Sparrowhawk.
Wren. But there's stormtroopers at the door.
There are. It's like a classic outbreak.
Yeah. Now, the shopkeeper.
Yeah.
He shows him his leather cased ID.
He does.
Doesn't he? Now, this will come in handy.
And he says, look, mate, they're really handy. I could do you a discount on them. And always he's trying to sell them. Maybe put them off a bit.
Yeah.
Because they know there's a Wookiee missing. There should be 4 Wookiees in this household.
Yes,
where's
because
the other one?
Marla and that, they've got this bookcase, shall we say, and that's where they've got this secret
IKEA.
Yeah. Wookiee version.
Yeah. It didn't look like a Wookiee version, it just looked like a bookcase.
Yeah. And that's where their secret communication device is. Or
Did you notice the trader suddenly closed up the hatch, didn't he?
Yes. And the stormtroopers, because they're going to search the place. And they nearly find. Yeah. They go to it.
Well, one of them opens it up.
Yeah, I know.
But he doesn't find it. No. What's this? I don't know.
Maybe the helmet was too big. He couldn't actually see out of that bit.
Yeah. It's probably got some, you know, like Google Glasses inside that helmet. He's watching that woman scene.
Yes. Yeah, well, yeah. Now, Marla got a present, didn't she?
Yeah.
Now, Mark, I don't know why she decides I'm going to do this while the stormtroopers are just destroying the house. Yeah, but Now, her present is Jefferson's starship.
The present that just keeps giving, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Because the trading post guy, because one of the Imperial guards is looking at it, he says, let me show you how it all works.
Yes. And he puts it on. And it's. And I would have thought you would have liked this because Jefferson's starship, for some reason, need to get naked with bare chests and everything. I have no idea what the song was.
It was specially written for this, you'll
was
be
it?
Glad to know, but it was released later.
Never appeared on any album. Only available on 7-inch.
It was an A-side, I have you know.
Was it really?
A-side.
Oh, God. No wonder they dropped the Jefferson bit. But
I've got, turn it off.
They're bare-chested. They've got like chaps things on, haven't they? Is this whole thing, they're just poor men, aren't they?
It was the fashions of the time.
Oh, he's got glowing makeup as well.
And the trooper's really happy watching it, though. He's ecstatic. I've not seen a naked man in such a long time.
He should have had little window wipers on his advisor.
And the guy in charge, he says, take the upper area to search.
Yes.
Which is Lumpy's room.
Where is the other Wookiee male?
Officer, maybe I could be of some help there, sir.
Who are you? And what are you doing in this Wookiee house?
Well, I'm the traitor in this district, you see. The truth of the matter is, she had a terrible fight with her husband, and he just stormed right out of
your here. Identification?
I said
your identification?
Oh, identification, yes. It's a very important thing, identification. I never leave the shop without my identification. It's very important. Just in times like this, you see, I just found my identification. I think it's in my pocket there.
Search the dwelling.
Obviously, you may notice that little leather case that I carry my identification card in. I whipped that up myself. That's a pretty fast-selling little item. And, well, some people like to keep things neat and clean, and that's why I have the little leather case for the identification card. As a matter of fact, if any of you guys want a couple of those leather cases, I've got a couple of extra ones there. Oh, officer, that picture you're looking at right now was taken quite a few years ago. That's one of me. I've gained quite a bit of weight since then.
Now, I've got Lumpy plays a game, but it's not really a game, it's a cartoon he's watching.
Yeah, no, yeah, I've got it. Well, first of all, I've got Lumpy is quiet and he starts watching. I've got Simon. Do you remember Pocket Simon?
Oh, yeah.
The little cut. Because that's what it is, isn't it, to start with?
Yeah.
And then suddenly, because this is what I can't work out. Well, it turns into a cartoon, doesn't it?
It does.
Star Wars.
It does.
And we've got the Falcons coming in fast.
Yeah.
Luke, R2, C-3PO, they all go to see what's happening because they realise, so this is the cartoon.
This is the cartoon,
what's happening, so they all go to the front.
And the Chewie and Han have gone to collect a talisman from somewhere.
Yes.
Starlog 3241, from the bridge of the cruiser RS Revenge, Captain Kaiser Han reporting. We are awaiting the return of Captain Han Solo and his first mate Chewbacca, who are long overdue on a delicate mission to acquire the mystical talisman which has been sought by our forces and by the Empire.
The talisman? It makes things invisible, I think. Yes, even you. Which I think might be an improvement.
We picked up something.
It's the Millennium Falcon.
They're coming out of light speed. I can't make contact.
Try a lower channel.
Falcon, do you copy? Come in, Falcon.
It's Chewie, but where's Han?
That's him hanging upside down.
I can't make radio contact.
He's on a collision course. Princess, we're in mortal danger from our own forces.
Falcon, do you copy?
This is madness.
You're right, General. I can't understand what Chewbacca's doing.
Okay. But they're coming in too fast.
Yeah.
And they're not responding to hails. And let's prepare to shoot. And Leia says, no, we can't shoot. And all this.
Now, suddenly,
Luke,
I've got it. Luke doesn't understand R2 anymore.
No.
Because R2's chatting away.
Yeah.
And Luke's like, what?
Well, I think he didn't into Empire, did he?
I don't know, because earlier on, when Luke's fixing the Dyson Hoover, he understands R2 fairly well. But suddenly in this cartoon, he doesn't.
He had an Apple Watch. It does all the translating
for him. Once the battery goes, that's it. They're a bugger.
And if you leave your phone too far away from it,
But they've landed on some sort of watery planet.
Yes.
Because the Falcon starts sinking, doesn't it?
Yes, and
I've got the Loch Ness Monster appears.
Yeah, because Luke takes a Y-Wing.
Yes.
And he takes C-3PO, because he won't be able to understand Chewie without C-3PO. And of course, R2 goes as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, because why not?
Well, why not? But the Loch Ness Monster appears, and it eats a power unit.
It does. It eats a bit of the ship.
Yeah.
But so Luke separates the pod bit of the... It's a Y-Wing, isn't it?
Yeah.
So he separates the top bit. But then they're saved.
Yeah, by Boba Fett.
By Boba Fett.
Boba Fett comes and saves them, and he says, I'm a friend. Don't worry, I'm here to help
you. I'm here to help you.
Now, R2 and C-3PO are not so sure.
No, they're not.
They're not so sure about
it. Boba Fett says, look, I'm no lover of the Empire.
Yeah. Yeah. And I can't remember why, but I've written down, Chewie gets rid of the talisman at this point, doesn't he?
Yeah, because it's something wrong. It's infected with a virus.
Yeah.
So he's throwing it down the garbage disposal.
Oh, that's
right,
it makes him all a bit sleepy, doesn't it?
It does. All humans it affects.
Yeah.
That's why Han Solo's hanging upside down when we see him.
Yeah.
Because that's the only way to keep him alive. Or
yeah, that's right, yeah. So Chewie gets rid of this. So, yeah, it's, at least say it's a sleeping virus.
Yeah, Luke passes out because of the sleeping virus.
Chewie and Boba...
Boba Fett captures Chewie because he thinks Chewie's gone rogue. But he says, no, Chewie's our friend.
Yeah.
And then it all comes... It's a sleeping virus from the talisman.
Yeah.
But Boba Fett knows where to get the cure.
Get the antidote,
It's an Imperial virus and he knows all about it.
Yeah. So they leave on some sort of strange... I don't know what that is. More Loch Ness monsters. But they go off, don't they?
There's a city nearby, luckily.
Luckily, on a water world.
Yeah. I've seen the film.
Oh, no. Wasn't a bad film.
It's an atoll.
Yeah.
I know exactly what it is. Boba Fett says, stay boy to Jimmy. More or less. Yeah. Mm. He says, you'll be caused too much.
He
just wants to separate.
He goes and finds the serum. But...
Oh no!
He's talking to Vader.
He is. He's going to turn.
He's been turned already.
Who thought Boba Fett would be a bad guy?
I didn't see it coming.
No.
I didn't see it coming.
Starlog update. Although Boba Fett quickly located the serum for the sleeping virus, we had no idea of his real plan.
And all is proceeding as you wish, Darth Vader.
But I want them alive. Now that you've gotten their trust, they may take you to their new base.
This time we'll get them all.
I see why they call you the best bounty hunter in the galaxy.
Lumpy, he goes back to Lumpy but now, who's playing the game.
He's a bit distressed, isn't he?
Yeah,
he's not clapping in this bit.
He's not happy, Granddad's itchy, still watching his porn, so he's alright.
luckily, R2-D2
goes back to the cartoon.
It intercepts the transmission.
Yeah.
And he knows that he's been talking to Vader.
Yes.
Boba Fett and Chewie are back to the ship. The drug works, okay. Han and Luke comes back up. And they say, oh, no. And Luke invites them back to his base.
Yes.
This was what they wanted all along.
Yeah.
He says, oh, Boba Fett is a stand-up guy. Come back to our secret hideout base with us. We've known you like 5 minutes. You seem okay.
Yes.
But no. No. But Chewie's not having it.
No, Chewie doesn't want him.
Then R2-D2 and C-3PO say, oh, look, here's a message to Vader. And Boba Fett runs away.
Well, I've got it. Because Han doesn't know Boba Fett.
No.
But I know in, obviously, The Empire.
Yeah.
Boba Fett comes, he goes to take Han, blah, blah, blah.
Boba Fett?
Yeah, but Boba Fett's here. Yeah. Now, is that supposed to be a carry-on from this?
Yeah. No, I can't remember. Do you remember when they changed the original Star Wars and put Boba Fett in it?
Did they?
Yeah, I can't remember if it was a deleted scene because Jabba the Hutt was supposed to be in it. He was played by a big... Scottish guy.
Yes.
But I think Boba Fett was actually there in that scene, wasn't he, in the background?
Yes, I think.
Or did they add him in
post? But it's just this.
Yeah, he doesn't know him at all.
He doesn't know him. Because, as you say, in Empire, when they're going to throw him into the pit.
He definitely knows him.
Yeah, he goes, Boba Fett's here. Where? Because he can't see him. And that's where it all, comic scene. And it all goes wrong. Now, is Han referring to this cartoon? Because obviously they've said Boba Fett is not a goodie, he's a baddie.
Yeah, it's going to be canon.
And so he's like, oh, there's a baddie with us? Yeah. Like surrounded by stormtroopers. But
it makes sense to me.
Yeah.
I think we'll go with that.
Yeah.
That's canon now.
Or is it because he's supposed to know Boba from way back?
Yeah.
It's never explained.
No.
And we'll leave it at that. But yeah, Boba Fett escapes.
Yeah, he just runs. I think he could have took him.
And I think, was it... Chewie says he didn't smell right.
Yeah, he smelt bad.
Yeah.
They all laugh at this.
Yeah. Now, this was the bit I couldn't work out. Obviously, Lumpy has watched this on the video. Now, all the stormtroopers are there.
Yeah.
But is this supposed to be a cartoon that Lumpy's watching of how we're destroying the Empire?
Yeah.
Which is, why would they allow him to watch that? It.
Yeah.
Is this supposed to be happening?
I think it's supposed to be like an adventure
series.
Serial, yeah, maybe.
And then it's like, but why would the Empire? Yeah. You've got stormtroopers wandering around. Why would they let you watch that? Because it makes them look like idiots.
Yeah. Well.
Well, mate, you're still watching the porn with it, lumpy.
Yeah, They search the house, they find nothing.
They find nothing.
Even though they've opened the secret panel.
Yeah.
And shut it again, obviously.
Yeah, they've wrecked the whole house, haven't they?
Oh, really? That Bantha ripped its head off.
I know.
Oh, Lumpy's Bantha.
Lumpy's Bantha, yeah.
Terrible.
But Lumpy goes up to clean his room. And he loves it.
And the guard says, oh, that should take a while. Because they've wrecked it.
Oh, yeah, they really have. Now, whilst Lumpy's sitting up there, he starts building a transmitter.
That's the thing the trader
gives. Yeah, that's what he's got given, yeah.
But luckily, you get a video on how to make your transmitter. Oh.
Yes.
God, this was bad.
I can't remember who did this.
This was Art Carney again.
Is it?
Yeah, he was the woman cook, and now he's the guy.
I thought this is Hedley the Mower.
Maybe it is.
This is Hedley.
Oh, yes. No, you're right.
Yeah. It's Hedley.
Hedley.
Yeah.
Lamar. Mm. He had such small feet.
Yeah, from great Mel Brooks movies. This is him, isn't it, doing this? And it was the only one I recognised.
But God, this scene is painful.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's a video man, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's supposed to be
like a robot.
Yeah, he's supposed to be a C-3PO, but with androids because he's got skin this time.
Yeah, and he keeps breaking down every so often.
And he's telling him how to build it.
In his mini transmitter.
Yeah.
It's just nonsense. It's just all nonsense.
It is absolute madness. Because he speeds up, he slows down. But he does it so badly.
Yeah, but it's hilarious. No, it's not.
No, it's not.
Oh, I'm not sure what they're going for. Maybe it's meta. Maybe.
I've no idea. But it is awful.
But Lumpy builds it, I've got.
Yeah. Now.
Now we get Life on Tatooine.
I've got that Life on Tatooine video.
Video.
Yeah.
And it's the cantina.
Yes. First of all, it's the stock footage of the bar, isn't it?
Yeah.
It is the film.
It is.
Yeah. Because the regulars are there.
They are.
On the film.
All the regulars.
They're all in there.
The demon's there. The werewolf.
Yeah.
They're all there.
They're all in there, yeah.
Yeah.
Now, we've got a barmaid.
Yes. What a barmaid.
Yeah.
And she is.
Oh, no, she clearly is.
And she definitely deserves one of these. Well, sorry, I've just turned it off.
Well, it doesn't matter.
I'll turn it back.
No one knows.
She's...
A woman.
You said it, sir.
Yeah, she is. And this guy hits on her, doesn't he?
Yeah, he is. He was in there last night and...
Yeah, and...
And she said something to him that made
three little words or something.
Five little words.
I think I did write it down. But yeah, and he says, "Oh, I had to come back and see you."
He's brought flowers.
And she's still like, "Yeah, what drink do you want?" And she's carrying on chatting to other people, and she's kind of half listening.
Yeah.
But he's pouring out his love for her, isn't
he says, "These words you said to me, come back soon. I'll be waiting."
Because she pours one drink into a bloke's head.
Yeah, yes, he is. He's got a head.
Oh, is it? Oh, it is him. Sorry, yeah.
No, it's him.
And, she breaks his heart, doesn't she?
Yeah. Because she says it's another customer.
Yeah, and then he realises.
And he just puts his hood up and then lays on the bar, and that's it.
Now, she wants everyone to leave because there's been another broadcast.
Curfew. Yeah. The curfew is everyone's got to clear the streets or whatever.
Yeah.
I don't see how it's her responsibility to clear the cantina.
No, I didn't understand that either.
No, but she wants everyone out. Maybe she's got
I don't know.
A heavy day of mopping her head. I don't know. But no one wants to leave, and no one's taking a blind bit of notice of her. And she goes, look, the party's over.
Yeah.
But they won't leave, and they start shouting, drink, drink, drink. And she goes, one more drink on the house.
Well, they put a gun on her.
One of them does, yeah.
Yeah, he pulls a gun on her.
Who would put a gun on B. Arthur?
I don't know.
No one. That's who. Yes.
And she goes, okay, one more round. Tab for the Empire.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's a song. There is a song.
Because she is talking to the cantina band, isn't she?
Yeah.
Whatever
they're there.
They are there, and they are in another song.
Yeah.
Which is basically... the same song they played in every film, just a different version of it. Yeah. And then I've got no one.
A lot of bands have got very far with just one song.
Yes.
And Rick Astley, he's done well out of one song.
Jefferson Starship.
Nothing's going to stop them now. And didn't they build this city?
Oh, God, I hate that.
On rock and roll.
I hate that song.
Built this city on rock and roll.
We built this town on sausage rolls.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. Did you see that? Number one.
I did, yeah.
They're the only third group in history
to have two consecutive number ones.
Only the Beatles and the Spice Girls. And now we've had one in our own town twice.
Baby Lad.
Baby Lad, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, good God.
And you usually find him by Greg's.
Yes. Yeah. Would you believe Ricky had his photo taken with him?
So did my daughter.
I thought it was bad enough. You'd stepped up. You were just blood related.
She showed me. She said, look, I've got a picture. Who's that then?
I wouldn't know either. No. I wouldn't know. Oh, I've seen him downtown. He wears a Knott's Forest shirt.
I've
seen him.
It's all for charity.
Yeah. So
what can we say?
Anyway. Back in the room.
Back in the room.
Oh, God, do we have to?
Yeah.
I don't want to go back.
We've got the Arthur song. Now, this is quality song. It's not as good as the song to come later, but this one, you know.
Oh, God, yeah.
Friends. All about friends.
Yeah.
All my friends are...
And I've got it. No wonder they left, but apparently I've got it. No, they're still there.
They're clambering to get out the door.
Yeah.
No, they're not.
No.
Good night, but not goodbye. Just one more drop, friend, before we stop, friend. One more moment, face to face. Next time you're dry, friend, try stopping by, friend, if there's a light in the place. We may not thrive, friend, but we survive, friend. Look, we're alive, friend, you and I. So say goodnight, friend. Good night, but not goodbye.
But eventually they all leave.
Yeah, they do all leave, and her and the band, and they say, okay.
And she's left with the weird guy with the hole in his head.
Yeah, and she actually starts coming on to him.
Yeah, because he's giving her a rose or something.
Yeah, and she likes him now. Yeah.
And that's a spin-off show, obviously.
Obviously, Joni loves charging.
We wish.
Yeah. The phone's going, hey.
The troopers were watching this all the time, all along. It turns out.
Yeah, I've known.
Because it then pans out and they've just seen all this song and all this stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
And they're laughing because, you know, I don't know why they're laughing.
No.
Look at these lower life forms, I think, is this thing. Anyway, the troopers need to return to base.
Yes.
But one trooper's to stay behind just in case that rebel turns up.
Yes, yep. He's going to wait for Chewie. Because they know it is Chewie. Well, they presume it's Chewie, don't they? But...
I've got a trooper confronts Lumpy.
Yeah, he goes upstairs, doesn't he? Yeah. And of course, he sees Lumpy on the machine. And he smashes it to pieces, doesn't he?
Because I weren't sure. Did Lumpy send the message for them all to return to base from his mini transmitter?
I think he does.
Or is he just picking up the mini transmitter?
I don't know.
If only I understood Wookiee.
This is three quarters in. I still didn't understand it. But he smashes up Lumpy's little machine.
He does.
And he chases Lumpy around.
Yeah.
Now, just as he's about to catch him, Chewie turns up. He's there.
And he's not happy.
No, he's not happy. And all this.
Yeah.
And let's be honest, if it weren't for the fact that he wears those, is it Balola, whatever, the round his shoulders, isn't it, with all these weapons, not the weapons, but
the rounds.
The belts, the rounds.
Ammunition belt, yeah. I think, maybe.
I couldn't have told him the difference between him and Marla. No.
I say sash. He's got a sash on.
Yeah, we'll call it that. Yeah, where's it with a sash?
He didn't get a medal. He gets a sash.
Yeah, but he's turned up and the
hand fights the actual guards.
Hands there with him.
And hands is hands on.
Definitely.
And he throws sort of the guard through the railing, sort of, but not really. But the guard does fall through the railing.
Yeah.
And as we said, it's painted to be a very long way down.
It's a very, very long way down. But they saved the day.
But the thing is, Lumpy was walking on that thing just
I know.
A little while ago.
Yeah. But what do you get from IKEA? Yeah, it's not all good stuff. But Han has to go.
He can't stay.
I can't stay here. I've got to go. We've only put 30p in the meter. And it's a long walk back.
It's okay, everybody. He's gone. How are you? Mom.
Wonderful.
Well, huh? Your son's been doing you proud. Saved my tail more than a couple times.
Mal, I'd love to, but I can't. I gotta get back to the Falcon before somebody stumbles across me. Hey, will you look at Lumpy? He's sure grown, huh? And I think his voice is changing. Come on, I'm just teasing. Well, I gotta go. Have a nice life, Dave, but be careful. A lot of troopers in the area. Chewie, check and see if the coast is clear, will you?
Now they're having happy families.
The Wookiees are reunited.
Yeah.
There's a knock at the door.
It's all happy though.
Who could it be?
Mr. Rogers.
It's the traitor again.
It's the shopkeeper again.
Yeah. And there's a communication comes
in. Has anyone seen that Mr. Ben? I can't find him anywhere.
And there's a Imperial Guard on the TV thing, and it says, B4711, come in, please. You've turned off your communicator.
Yes.
Where are you, B4711?
Well, obviously, that's the guy who stepped out for a breather. Still breathing all the way down.
Why that first step?
That's a killer.
Yeah. But the trainer's got this in hand. He says, lucky he's got his leather-bound ID.
Yes.
And he communicates with the guard. He says, look, they left the one stormtrooper here. He grabbed a load of food and money and took off to the hills.
Yeah, he said, yeah, he's robbed them and he's left. Yeah. Oh. I would have thought that
of 147. No, he didn't seem the time.
No.
B471A.
Oh, well.
He definitely was the type.
He was the type.
He was a one. He was a one, that one.
You could see it in his eyes.
Yeah. So they said they're going to send out a search party to find him.
Yeah.
You'd find him at the bottom of the train. Because no one's clearing out that mess.
He's down there.
We have two-way communication, Traitor Sandan. Is this a report about the missing trooper?
It is, sir. Trooper B4711 was here with three other men. They left and he remained. As soon as they had gone, he packed a lot of food from this house and he robbed me blind. Then he took off for the hills.
Very well, we'll send out a search party.
Thank you. Yes, sir. Identification is very important. Helps you.
Now, I don't know why, but they've all got glowy baubles.
It's a life day thing. Even Marla's got a glowy bauble.
She has got glowy baubles. Yes, I noticed. Well, Chewie's own.
The glowy baubles are all in the air, sort of.
And suddenly they've got
robes.
They've all got Jedi robes on.
Now, this is a more confusing ending than the film The Black Hole, and I was always confused by that.
Now, they floated off into space, or into the light, right. I'm not sure why.
Yeah.
To the Tree of Life?
But yes, the Tree of Life.
Is I presumed it was the Tree of Life, honestly. No.
And you Jackmans know where to be found.
No. And they're all gathered around.
Yeah.
They're all gathered around. And R2 and C-3PO are now there.
Yeah.
I don't know.
No.
And now the gang's all here.
Leia, Luke, Han, they all show up.
Everyone's there, because Han said he was going earlier, but now he's there.
And now Leia gets to sing.
Yeah.
I love this song.
Now this was the bit that shocked me more than anything. Because she starts to give a speech, doesn't she?
Yeah, she does.
It's happy life day.
Princess Leia, she can give speeches.
She's Princess Leia. And then she's singing, and I'm thinking, and it really is her singing.
It is her. Well, she's Debbie Reynolds.
I know.
She can sing. The family trait must have run through.
She's singing.
Yeah.
Princess Leia.
Singing. It's when Han joins in.
Well,
And Luke's the backup, yeah.
And we get some flashbacks.
Yeah, we get of the film.
We can get that in.
Good film.
Yeah. And
then it's the end, isn't it? Oh, no, we have a Wookiee mealtime. What? Then it's the end. There's a Wookiee sort of meal where they're all sitting around eating, like Thanksgiving or Christmas.
Yeah, yeah, got glowing balls. They've still got their glowing balls. Yeah. And they're going to join hands and pray.
Yeah.
And that is it.
That is.
And that is, as you say.
Yeah.
This holiday is yours. But we all share with you the hope that this day brings us closer to freedom and to harmony and to peace. No matter how different we appear, we're all the same in our struggle against the powers of evil and darkness. I hope that this day will always be a day of joy in which we can reconfirm our dedication and our courage, and more than anything else, our love for one another. This is the promise of the Tree of Life. We celebrate a day of peace, a day of harmony.
And so you came up at the end, as you say, Marla is played by a man.
Yes.
It's like, really?
Yeah.
And at no point...
He moved in such a feminine way.
He did, well.
From Wookiee, yeah.
And at no point in the end of these credits does Lucas's name actually come up anywhere to do with this.
Damn right it doesn't.
Now, I don't know if that's because of that's what he wanted or it's been edited since...
Well, I think he was busy making Empire at this time.
Yeah.
And so the CBS had come to him saying, oh, we want to do a Star Wars special. And he was thinking, oh, that's good, because Empire won't be out for a few years. You know, so this will keep Star Wars in people's mind. And he said he'd like it to be based on Chewie's family and his home life. Mm. So they kept that bit.
Yeah.
But then he said he had nothing to do with it apart from that. But I think he must have seen it before it went out. Surely he would have.
He'd have to have given it his okay.
Yeah, he's going to have a nod.
He has to, because he can't... He'd have to check it to make sure they give nothing away of the Empire.
But they wouldn't know. I think it was in early production at the time.
But even so, if they gave...
They can't contradict anything that would happen.
That would happen in Empire. And if...
Oh no, Wookiee, Chewie has his arm cut off in this. And
that's the point, that's what I'm saying, yeah. They can't give something away that he would later use in evidence. I mean, that he would later go, well, like you said, yeah, you can't have Chewie's arm off.
No.
This is the film. Or you can't say that, I don't know, that Princess Leia and that are brother and sister, because that's the whole point.
Yeah, and it weren't yet. No. I mean, I'm sorry for you all out. You know, of course they were all the time.
Yeah,
we know. Well, as you may know, George Lucas went to buy all the master copies of this.
Yes, he said.
But he was unable to. He said if he had a sledgehammer enough time, he'd destroy every bootleg copy he found.
You've got to... Why? Why did they do this?
Yeah, Carrie wanted to sing. That's the only reason she agreed to do it, because she wanted to do a song at the end.
Okay. Okay.
Sean Dawn, I think that's the Trading Post guy, was actually the early version of Lando Calrissian. Lando Calrissian was eventually going to be a Trading Post guy on the Wookiee home planet, but of course it got changed as things went on. Yeah.
But it's like... But it's just some of the scenes are so... They are... They are very close to the knuckle.
Yeah.
In 78, these are quite close. Yeah. You know, and it's like, you can't do this for a kid's holiday special.
And Star Wars was big. Oh, I mean, you may forget how big it was, but it was big.
Oh, it was massive, yeah. Now, but the Americans got it in 77. We got it in 78.
No, we got it in 77. No. December 77.
Yeah, right? So it's a good year later.
Yeah, they got it mid-summer.
Yeah, they had it about 6 months earlier, didn't they, from what we got.
Yeah.
And it's just a year, but they didn't expect the toys to last.
No, they didn't expect it to keep...
Yeah.
Because mostly everything that had been licensed to a film, toys, they just... As soon as the film was gone from...
That was it.
That was it. Got it.
Yeah, but this one broke all boundaries.
Yeah, it just kept coming, didn't it? I mean, Kenner, or what they made out of this. I mean, as I said, the toys have made like five times whatever the movies have made. Probably even more.
Yeah, Alec Guinness did quite all right with this one, didn't he?
Yeah, he got a percentage, didn't he?
He got a percentage of the toys.
I don't know, he got a percentage of the box office.
Is it? I thought it was the toys as well.
Maybe.
I thought he got a percentage of most of... Because Lucas was so desperate, he didn't have any money left. Didn't he? Oh, go on then. But either way, he's done all right out of it.
Now, though it's strange...
You wouldn't say.
Yeah. There was recently people who put the bootleg up on, like, cinema, and people came in to watch it. And Fox licensed it, or CBS, or whoever had the license, licensed it, agreed, even though it was a bootleg copy.
Okay.
But all the licenses were revoked and pulled in 2019. Now Disney have got it, I suppose.
Yeah, Disney own it now.
None of the cast will ever talk about it. The only one who would talk about it was Carrie Fisher, because she was quite straight, blunt and straightforward, weren't she? When she
oh, God, yes, yeah. She never. And you forget, because it's been a year, long time since I've seen her. She's a very attractive young lady, wasn't she?
She was amazing. Looking, yeah.
And you forget.
Yeah.
Because it's been years since I've seen the original Star Wars.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
blimey. But yeah, it was just strange, her singing.
Yeah.
What? Where did that come from?
I've read it here. The Jefferson Starship song was Light the Sky on Fire. If you want to get the MP3 of that and...
burn it.
And then wear your chaps.
Bare chest.
Yeah. Listen to that.
But this was just bizarre. It really is.
What bits did you find entertaining?
The end. When the credits came up.
I think it was like an hour and 35 minutes.
It's long.
And it was a long hour and 35 minutes.
God, is it long.
God, I thought it's never going to end.
Well, it's just when it starts and they're talking. Okay, and you think, okay.
No, yeah, stop.
This is just the start of it. I'll get this. This will come. It will change later. No. No, it never does. And it's just Grandpa. It's like everything he watches is porn. It's like, this is
kids.
There's
nothing much in his life at that moment, no.
It's for children.
His wife's probably died or fallen out the tree.
Because isn't it, if I remember, is it in this one where Lumpy's playing with the whittled down X-Wings and all that? And he's got the real noises from the film, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Who's making them? He's like, do, what?
It's a bizarre thing, isn't
it? It's extremely strange.
And I can't believe you'd never heard.
I'd never heard of this. I'd never seen it.
And that was the first time you watched it.
It was. That's why I watched it all. You skipped, but I watched the whole thing because I thought I've got to.
I have watched it before, but... I think
it's a good copy.
Yeah, it was. It was all right, wasn't it?
Yeah,
it's all right.
Which made it even worse. Because I could clearly see how
the
bad
sound
it was.
Good. The tracking, but you know, they pulled the Incredible Hulk and Wonder Woman off to show this.
Yes, they say that, don't they? It keeps coming up, doesn't it? Yeah. There's a
normal programming will return next week.
Yes, with the Incredible Hulk
and Wonder Woman.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
They must have been down on their viewing figures for them to put this on. But
it was Star Wars, though.
It's Star Wars. It was a major coup.
I mean,
coup.
If you'd been... Well, we were kids at the time.
Well, yeah, we were.
You think if there's a Star Wars special, you'd watch it.
Oh, yeah, we would
have. And even though it was awful to start off with, you're thinking, well, it's going to get better.
Hmm.
It's going to get better. Then you'd get to the point of Carrie Fisher singing if you can... It's not going to get any better, is it?
But luckily, it's finished.
That's credits. Roll credits.
Yeah. But we never got it in this country.
We didn't. They quickly pulled it.
Yeah.
I think it only got one proper showing.
It must be that version.
That
is it.
Well, it was shown, obviously, throughout regions in Australia.
Yeah, yeah.
Australia had shown it as well.
Okay.
I think Canada had shown it before America.
The convicts got it before we got it.
I believe. I'm not 100% sure.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Maybe they spared us. Maybe Lucas thought, look, we make the films over there.
We need to go back.
We need to go back. We can't let them see this.
We're going to be filming Empire there.
I've got another two films. I know. God knows what's going to happen in them, but I can't let them see this.
So, obviously, this was... They thought they could do a few of these.
Did they? Yeah.
I mean, because these are like holiday spectaculars, you know. They are similar to shows of the time.
Yes.
But none of them were based on Star Wars. I'm sure Bob Hope did a number of these type of variety shows.
Yes.
But not one on Star Wars.
Not one on Star Wars. And it's just bizarre. And it's just... one minute it looks like it's well done. The next minute it's made so cheaply. It's unbelievable.
It's like in the cantina, all the aliens are there. They're the ones
from
the film.
Yes, and there are a few extras.
Yeah.
So they've got the official costumes for them.
Yes, yeah.
And then you've got Hedley Lamarr pretending he's a robot. What? What's going on here? Yeah. Strange.
But if you had to score this out of 10...
please don't make me. This is up with the monkeys.
It is.
The monkeys reunion.
The new monkeys.
Oh, God, this was awful.
But it's Star Wars.
But it's Star Wars, I know. But we have to mark it on the strength of this one show. Because, you know, Batman, opening pilot Batman, brilliant.
Yeah.
Still loved it, so everything is there you want. Brilliant. This, God.
There's nothing you want there.
No.
I don't care about Chewie and his family, sorry.
No. Life Day. No, what's all this?
Well, because obviously they didn't want to say, oh, Christmas, because it's a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away.
So yeah.
Didn't have Christmas.
But the thing is, it looks like the Wookiees have overtaken the Ewok city.
It does, doesn't it? Looks very Ewok-like.
When you see the Wookiees, I'm sure in another film, they don't live in trees like that.
I can't remember if they do or don't.
When there's the big battle scene, with all the Wookiees
fighting. One of the prequels.
Yeah. That's on their world, if I'm right. They don't live in tree houses like that. I'm sure they don't.
Maybe they wanted to.
Maybe the Ewoks kicked them out, well, I don't know.
Maybe it's like us and the red squirrels and the grey squirrels.
Yes.
The grey squirrels are bigger than the red squirrels.
Yes.
And they just overrun them.
They did.
So the Wookiees are bigger than the Ewoks.
Yes.
And they're not indigenous. And they just overrun the Ewoks.
Yeah.
They use them as rugs and carpets.
Are the indigenous tribe.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's possible.
Yeah,
you could likely be onto a rig.
it's the basis of my new book.
Ewoks and where they went wrong.
The decline of the Ewok civilization.
The Ewoks strike back.
Introduce one Wookiee into their planet and let's say it took.
Yeah,
they're gone.
It's it, isn't it? There goes the neighbourhood. Bring back the space ballers. I'll give it five.
Just, five?
Yeah, I'm giving it in middling because it's Star Wars and I can't.
But, yeah. To be honest, I've got to give it a five as well, I think, because I do love Carrie Fisher.
Yeah. It is Star Wars.
And she's there, and Harrison Ford's there, and Mark Hamill's there.
Makeup.
A lot of makeup.
A lot of makeup. But yeah.
We'd all have them days.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, it's bad.
So that's it.
That is it.
That's your final show.
Well, for a long while.
That's your final show.
It could be my final. Well, okay, it's my final show. Am I leaving?
Yeah, you're leaving.
You set something up. Okay, what have you got?
Well, I haven't done much. obviously, when you break up a partnership, the best way to do it is by text, which, of course, you technically said, I don't want to do anymore. So
that's traditional. Yeah. I'm going with the kids.
You've done it with many a woman. But anyway.
Never with a man.
I thought I've got to do you a little poem, haven't I, or something to...
Oh, God.
And I thought, well, I could start off with something like...
No, say Brian's brilliant. Go on. I know you're going with it.
Well, I could do that.
Brian's brilliant.
Yeah, but that's Dave. and then we have the...
Silence.
She used to give me roses.
The sad song at the end, you know.
I wish he could again.
If you're in on about the sweets. Yeah. Not the flower.
You only brought me Quality Street, though. That's not what I asked for. You used to bring me roses.
Yeah, but I like Quality Street.
I thought we could really, you know, sum up my feelings. We could only have one song that would do it. On the piano, please.
God, not this song. Oh, no.
I'm not sure where the intro comes in, so...
God, I like this song. You're going to sing the whole bloody thing. You are, aren't you?
Yeah, at first I was afraid, I was petrified, thinking I could never live without you by my side.
Nice.
But I spent so many nights thinking how you did my podcast wrong, and I grew strong. I learned how to get along. And so you're back, what's it, from outer space? You just walked in to find you here with that stupid look upon your face.
Hey.
I should have got a stupid knock, I should have made you need a key. If I'd known for just one second, you'll be back to bother me.
That's why you had the wasp, isn't it? The wasp is my replacement.
Boy, go! Walk out that door!
Oh, we're in a minute.
Just turn around now, because you're not welcome anymore. Aren't you the one who tried to destroy this podcast with goodbye?
Yes.
Did you think it had crumbled?
No.
Did you think it had laid down and died?
No.
Oh no, not launching the pilot!
Oh, God.
I actually printed the words far too small for me to read without my glasses.
Yeah, you can't read that, can you?
I can't.
many a well thought through plan crumbled. The first sight of I can't see it. It's actually the wife's shopping list.
So that's 200, episode 200?
Episode 200. And I didn't do all of them.
Oh, no, you didn't. Well, did you do about 20? Maybe that. I can't remember.
No one noticed.
I'm not keeping count.
No one noticed anyway. No.
But that's it. You're out. You're
that's
free.
It. I'm out.
Free. You have your time to yourself again.
Free.
No enough. More. You have to watch the Star Wars Holiday Special.
Yeah. See, now I've gone out on a bang, haven't I?
Yeah. Oh, I chose it for a reason. Yeah. I wanted you to suffer.
No, you made me suffer big style. Yes, that's
so,
it.
But out of the 200 odd shows, the
odd 20 that I did.
The 20 you did. There must have been some highlights, some shows you thought, oh, this is actually a good show.
Yeah, Batman.
Yeah.
1966.
Come on.
The birds.
Come on, Adam Adamant. You know you loved it.
Yeah, it wasn't bad.
The New Monkees. You've never watched it without me.
No. Bloody right. And that's one of the reasons. And that was in my resume. That's why I'm going...
Obviously, I'm sad that you didn't get to do The Love Boat and The Love Boat, The Next Wave. Yeah, but I did make you do both Fantasy Island. So.
Yeah, which I didn't mind because I like the original Fantasy Island.
And you like the sequel, the follow-up, reboot as well.
Yes. Yeah, it wasn't so bad. Must admit, it wasn't so bad. But we've had some rough ones.
Oh, God, yeah.
Star Wars Holiday Special.
That seems to stick in your mind.
That doesn't it? Yeah. Well, other ones, well, New Monkees, clearly.
Yeah. These are just the bad ones you're thinking of.
Oh, God, yeah, what other one was? What was...
I've got the list somewhere, but I can't...
Yeah, I can't remember. Space 1999, that's where it all went wrong.
So, yeah, we should have done that one.
That was the one that was where it all went wrong there.
Well, do you remember we were going to do the podcast? Oh, let's do Space 99. I just threw it out there randomly. And we watched it about three or four times before we actually got to talk about it.
Yes.
And we were sick of it by the time we got to it.
My God, was we. Yeah. Yeah. You got to do the Bionic Woman, or you
hope? I want to do the Bionic Woman, yeah, still. Yeah. Oh, I did do her. Yeah. Both versions.
Well, let's not forget, because his picture is there. We did the Shatner.
We did the Shatner.
We did him in his... Not only did we do Star Trek.
But that's all we did.
No. No.
He was in nothing else.
We did him when he was... Alexander the Great. Yeah. How could you forget that? That was one of his finest moments. Batman.
It was something else. Yeah, we never got to do TJ Hooker.
No, we didn't do TJ Hooker.
I've got the disc just sitting on there on the shelf.
Was it Heather Locklear, TJ Hooker?
Yes, Heather Locklear.
Yeah,
so Heather Thompson was in The Fall Guy.
It was The Fall Guy. We always get it wrong, yeah.
I would be happy with either Heather.
I know, yeah. You'd love to roll in Heather, don't you? But we did the Shatner, and that's, that's the pinnacle.
Would you have known that Scott Bakula was Iron Man?
No. You would. Does anybody else know? Even he denies that he's Iron Man.
You wouldn't have seen him in the shower.
No,
oh boy. Yeah.
Yeah, see, things, you remember certain things, don't you? You remember all the shower scenes of everything we've ever watched.
I'm doing Buck Rogers.
Buck Rogers, yeah, old Commander Deering.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, bitty. Old Buck.
Electro Woman, Dinah Gale.
Oh, brilliant.
I've still got that audio commentary we did. I've put it together with the video. It could be released, depending. Yeah. Unless I get some large sums of money, it may be released.
And let's not forget.
Yeah.
Let's not forget. What was it? Thunderboat or whatever it is.
Thundering Paradise.
Yeah. The head. The sculpting of the. What do you want to be?
To be a sculptor. I still remember that.
It's still the funniest thing we ever did.
It just comes out of the blue.
And the boat that doesn't end. It's as deep as an ocean.
It makes the TARDIS look tiny.
It just carried on going.
It was just a normal speedboat.
No, it wasn't.
I'll tell you what, I was watching...
It made the Marianas Trench.
I was watching the Grand Tour the other day. Okay, all right. Sometimes I lower my standards.
Yeah, you did that.
From New Monkees to Grand... And they were going across the Vietnam on boats.
All right, yeah.
And Richard Hammond.
Yeah.
He had the Thunder in Paradise boat that was specially built for the series.
All right.
Not the actual one, but this model of boat was built because of the series. And it was on one end. It didn't look that big.
No. And Richard Hammond's small.
small,
that's the point. I mean, this had, not only did it have the Hulk on there, who else? There was another. There was Brutus, Beefcake in there.
Yeah, there was two Beefcakes.
There were some big people on that boat.
And your jet skis.
Yeah. And it had its own diving port.
And computer room.
Yeah.
It's like when it went down.
It just kept going down. It's had a lift.
Went down into it, where the computer room was, and said, we better get the women below. And then open a hatch to go down the
It's got a lift. Yeah. It's the only boat I've seen that's got a lift.
It was fast.
I don't know how.
I think we theorised that maybe the weld moved around the boat. The boat stayed stationary.
But still, it's the head sculpting scene.
Because it come out of nowhere.
It's the hello, Lionel Richie. And it looked like Lionel Richie.
It just come out of nowhere.
Yeah, what do you want to be? I wanted to be a sculptor.
Yeah, I don't think we both cracked up.
We both knew what was coming. Yeah, that's probably the classic, that one.
That was... That's when we knew the podcast wouldn't work.
Yeah. Yes. Oh, God.
But now that's you finished.
That's me. Well, released.
As you shed a tear.
Yeah. Just speaking of the head skull. Oh, you could have at least presented me with the head skull. Here's what I've done for you. Oh, dear. Yeah, funny. Should we talk about the real Star Wars now?
We can do, can't we?
Because we've seen it.
We've both seen it. And yes, it'll be a few months after it's been out when this comes out.
Yeah, I went with the wife to see this.
I went with my son first time, then second time with my two younger sons and my wife. Mm. I think she was knitting in the back. I'm not sure.
No, Julie watched it. And the first thing she came out with at the end.
Yeah.
And I must admit, I was about to say the same thing.
What's the Star Wars?
No.
All right.
Was... what washing powder does Rey use? Because throughout the whole film, it was whiter than white. And she'd rolled across dirty decks and got it.
She's been swallowed by that muddy stuff.
Yeah, pure white.
Pure white.
Pure white. Until the final scene, she's coming home and she had a bit of dirt. And we're like, what?
She forced cleaned it.
Obviously.
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 Look, some people are moaning. How did Rey know how to do this or that? How could she pull a ship out of the sky?
Yeah, the ship out of the sky was a bit...
But she had the Jedi books, and it probably... Ship pulling out of the sky was probably page one.
Well, probably. And
because she took the books in the Last Jedi. She did take...
Yes. Although we don't know what she did with them.
She read them.
Well, no, yeah, but when she took them afterwards. And this was the point I was going to say with the Stormtrooper thing. What's the point? Because every shot anyone ever takes at a Stormtrooper is guaranteed to pierce that armour.
It's not the best armour. I think they bought a job lot from paintball.
every shot anyone takes hits them, they're down.
Yeah.
Man down. Now, the Stormtrooper took a shot, let's just say for this one film, but obviously other films, Poe.
Yeah.
Hits him in the arm. It's a flesh wound, don't worry, I'll carry on.
He had special armoured clothing on.
Yeah, very thin. Yeah. Kevlar style.
Kevlar.
Shoot a stormtrooper in the arm, he's down.
Remember when we watched The Terminator,
whatever it was called. For us to say.
She had Teflon furniture.
That's true. I forgot about that.
Yeah, so it is a thing. Yeah.
What is the point of Stormtrooper armour?
I've never worked that one out.
No, because it does nothing, just deflect anything.
There is a bit going around, because obviously Finn was a former Stormtrooper.
He was, indeed. And then apparently everyone was.
Then he met a load of other former Stormtroopers.
Yes.
But then they're happy to kill Stormtroopers.
Yes, who could be their mates. Yeah. Oh, no. Who are on the verge of, I'm thinking of chucking his thing tonight, you know.
Hey Finn, it's me, Jerry. Yeah. And he gives a nice woo as he does it.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. It's,
do you think it was a mess of a film?
I didn't mind it.
It's not the worst.
It's not the worst.
It's not the best.
No. Because, again, maybe I'm picking this up wrong with the Stormtroopers, because you have to... Because, obviously, in the prequels,
yeah,
they're all supposed to be clones of Jango, Bobo, whoever that
yeah,
is.
Yeah, yeah.
Whoever. But when did they turn into normal
people? Yeah. I think when the First Order arose.
But you never see. You just assume they're always the same.
Yeah. It's never said, but they do mention in The Force Awakens that they were raised.
Yeah, but they're all raised as
the children
clones of...
No, they were children who their cat...
Oh, are they? I
think there's a throwaway bit to it.
I did miss that bit then. But I didn't mind the film.
No, I felt that it was about 2.5 hours, would you say?
Yeah.
It needed to be 5 to fit some plot in there.
Yeah.
Instead of just going from here to here, oh, we've got to get this MacGuffin to that MacGuffin.
It moves very fast.
There's no time for characters or rests.
No, it does move very, very quickly.
Yeah. Of course, obviously, our Princess Leia has died. Carrie Fisher.
She's in this a lot.
She's in this a bit. Obviously, old stock footage, which they've adapted.
Well, I think they'd already filmed a lot of it, hadn't they?
No, they hadn't filmed any.
I hadn't filmed her part.
No, but she was in The Last Jedi. She'd filmed that, and she'd... But then she'd... And this was a lot of Force Awakens cutscenes. So she was being surreal
and
in her comics.
She got lead title, didn't she?
Yeah, yeah. Now, obviously, we know she's dead, so she couldn't have been in it. So the scenes did stand out a little bit. Yeah. I just think if you didn't know she died, would they
also
stand out?
The bit where she had her own lightsaber.
Well, of course she does. I've got a lightsaber. Why would she?
It has never ever been mentioned before that she's got her own lightsaber.
She was trained in the Force.
Yeah, and that's never been mentioned before.
There was a time period she could have been.
It was also the fact, it did get me, was the... We had to get everybody in. We even got the cutscene of the Ewoks in.
Yes, we did, didn't we?
Everybody was in. Han was in it.
Well, you rounded up. You rounded up a...
The Ewoks are in it.
9 films.
We had the voice of Vader. Why did we have the voice of Vader? Only because no one knows what... Anakin sounds like as a man because he's dying. So how do we? So it's easier to use Vader's voice.
Yeah,
we've got Yoda's in there.
Yeah,
everybody was in.
Loads of voices in it.
Yeah,
I could have identified them all. That's rounding up 9 films. You've got to include everybody.
Yeah, and it's like she's at the Skywalker Ranch, and it was just Luke and Leia.
What? Skywalker Ranch? That's where George Lucas...
Well, it's Skywalker...
Home.
Yeah, the home.
It was Uncle Owen's home.
Yeah.
Moist Farmer Extreme.
I'm sure.
It was Luke's home for a bit.
Yeah. But I don't think Leia had ever been there, had she?
No.
No, she knew the way. It was a ghost.
She was in royalty. She was a princess.
Yeah.
He was a moist farmer. That's who got the end of that stick, eh? Of course, her planet did get blown up, so.
Yeah. Fair enough. And as someone else pointed out, when the woman says, "Who are you?" "Rey." "Rey who?" No one says, "Skoke."
"What's your family name?"
Yeah, you just go, "Oh, Rey." "Oh, all right."
Yeah.
No one goes, "Who?
What's your date of birth?" "What province are you from?"
Yeah, I'm a Skywalker. We didn't get Ren. He didn't reappear.
Ren?
Kylo. He
as a false ghost?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought you might, but you didn't, did
but
you?
But you didn't, did you?
I was sort of hoping you'd get Adrian Christian in there.
Yeah.
But
No.
But I think there was too much to fill the story with. It needed time to slow down.
Yes, because it is fast.
Yeah, and a lot of things is obvious that obviously The Last Jedi wasn't done by J.J. Abrams, it was done by Rian Johnson.
Yeah.
And he changed a lot of the stuff that obviously J.J. had set up in the first film.
Yeah.
And J.J. wanted to change it back. And he had to do that and make the film. And I think Star Wars works when it's just a simple story.
Yes.
You know, we're going here, we're going to blow up the Death Star.
Yep, that was
which we've done 3 times, but but like even Rogue One, they've got to get the plans. The story is they've got to go and get the plans.
They've got to get the plans.
It's straightforward.
We know that leads on to the New Hope, so we know they're going to get the plans. So we kind of know it's like the Titanic. We know what's going to happen, but
get fun on the way.
Yeah, but we're gonna. We have to get there.
Yeah. And I think the story was just, why did they need that triangle thing to find the Emperor? Did it matter if they found the Emperor?
No.
How's he built all them ships?
I've no idea how he built all those ships.
He was busy.
My God, he was busy, really.
You know, I think, you know, if I tidy the house, do a bit of hoovering, I've had a good day. Yeah. God, that's nothing to compare to the Emperor's day, surely.
No. And let's face it, he was wired up to some sort of machine.
And I thought, you know, when he had all that crowd all around him?
Which, presumably, are Siths.
Siths, yeah. I thought they were all going to be clones of him. I thought, oh, that's going to be the reveal. They're all the Emperor or something.
Yeah.
But they weren't. It was just...
Well, you don't know what they were. You never see them.
No.
You never actually see
just
them.
In the background all the time.
Yeah.
And do you need every Star Destroyer to be able to destroy a planet?
No. Well, I suppose it's in the name.
Well, they thought of the name first, didn't they?
Well, yeah, because they didn't have that capability to start with.
If you've got that many ships, you wouldn't need them to...
Well, I think the idea is they're going to spread across the galaxies.
Yes. Yeah, but, you know, four or five of them could probably wreck havoc.
They'd do
planet.
A very good job, wouldn't they?
No, they'd make every place look like Luton in no time.
Oh, easily.
Yeah, hive of scum and villainy. I didn't hate it.
No, I didn't hate it. It's just, it's fast, it's full on.
I think it needed more story.
Yeah.
Or just a simplified story.
Simplified,
I mean, at Palpatine, I've sent a radio message out. It's my own podcast, you know.
Yeah.
I'm back.
Yeah, hiya people.
Look who's back. Back again, you know?
Guess who's back.
Yeah, I mean,
I know.
It seems like there's too much missing there.
Yeah.
That's fine, he could be a clone, I think he probably was, they never said.
No, it's full on, it's fast.
Did you see the little Snokes in tubs?
No.
Yeah, they had a couple of Snokes in tubs that they were clones, like.
Oh, I know he said I made him.
Yeah, he was like my puppet, yeah.
Yeah.
Puppet dude.
Yeah, it was... And it's just like, suddenly... As the films have progressed, they've got more powers than anyone's ever seen these people have before.
I remember when Luke Skywalker couldn't even get the lightsaber to his hand in the first film. There was none of this.
Now she can pull down a spaceship.
Ship. Yeah.
And so can Ren.
Yeah.
They can both do it.
Yeah.
And now we can FaceTime each other in the same room.
Yeah.
And somehow interact with each other. But not see where the other one is.
Yeah.
So we can interact, we can touch each other.
But I don't know where you are.
But I don't know where you are.
Yeah.
You're not, okay.
Maybe it's a bit like, remember that game Nightmare? Where am I?
Yeah.
You're in a room.
Yeah. Don't go that way.
Two steps forward.
Yeah. Yeah, because that's what they're saying was, I've read somewhere, because when she buries the two lightsabers,
yeah.
Who's has she got?
She made one.
She's made one. But at no point, again, have you ever seen her make one?
It's in the Jedi books.
Yeah.
How to make one. Easy assembly.
Well, when did Leia ever have one?
Yeah.
When did she make one?
Yeah.
And is this why when Kylo is trying to get him one of the... I think it's the first one. Tries to get the light, so it won't come to him because it's Luke's.
Or is she just more powerful?
No, it's supposed to be that Luke's got... Cyber has called her, hasn't it?
Yeah.
That's why she finds it.
That's right, yeah.
It's calling her. Yeah. And when they're fighting in the jungle, in it, or whatever, it won't go to him because it's Kylo and it won't go to you.
That's a story for another time.
Yeah, well, clearly, we know what's going to happen. She's buried two lightsabers. Well, I wonder if someone will find them later on.
No, because we're done with... That's it. No more of this story.
Someone will find
the stories. Lightsabers. I'm hoping for Uncle Owen... The farm years.
It's got to be better than Chewie, the life day.
Yeah. Because, you know, Uncle Owen, you think he's dead, but could you identify them corpses?
No.
They were burnt to a crisp.
That's true.
I think if you want to get away from moist filming, what's the perfect time to do it?
Yeah.
You know, the stormtroopers have been, people have known, have come round. Stormtroopers probably left, saying, oh, well, the droids aren't here. We'll just go.
Yeah.
Yeah, bye then. Because, you know what? This could be our get out plan. We've burnt the whole thing down.
Yeah. Get the insurance.
Yeah. We move a couple of valleys down. We'll start another moist...
Maybe we get the... is it the Jar Jars or what? Not the Jar Jars. The...
Sand people?
Yeah, the sand... Not the sand people, the other ones. Lieutenant!
They are Jar.
Are they?
Jar. No, not Jar 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 Binks.
Not Jar Jar Binks.
Jowers.
Jowers, that's it, Jowers. Where do we get the Jowa years?
Lieutenant! It's got a lot of dialogue.
Lieutenant!
It's like the commentary track for Spaceballs.
Yeah.
It's just, make it or something, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's just,
yeah, that's what we want.
Yeah.
That's what we want.
So you haven't watched The Mandalorian at all?
No.
Well, neither have I, because it's not available in the UK.
No.
But it's quite good. You should watch it when it comes out in March.
Yeah, I only like the movies.
I'm guessing it's good from what I've heard. I've never
watched the Clone Wars things either.
No, I haven't either. That you're not a true fan.
I watched the films, and that's where it started, and that's where it finishes. The films.
How many of these people queued up in the rain to see the 1977 release?
Yeah, we did. Yeah, we were there.
Twice had to queue up because didn't get in the first time.
No, I know.
That's how busy it was.
Yeah, we were there.
Yeah.
None of you, we were there, have watched you.
We watched it when George Lucas brought him out again. Don't care.
Yeah.
I think if you like something, then you're a fan, surely. It doesn't matter how in deep you are into it, if you haven't read all the novels or books or...
Yeah, yeah. Or looked at every facet of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, no, I shan't be seeing The Mandalorians.
I'm a Lindsay Wagner fan. I've never been inside her. So.
Oh, God. Is that going to be the last bit on the podcast?
No, I cut that bit out. I cut nothing.
Let's see.
What do you do with your free time? Are you going to start a rival podcast?
No.
Land in the pilot.
Land in the pilot. Pilot should never take off.
Well, you said you'll come back from some guest appearances.
Well, I'm sure I'll sort something out at some point.
Oh, well,
not next week.
That's committal for you, isn't
it? I'm not going to commit. No, you're not putting me to a contract. It's taking me this long to break it.
I've gone
to so many lawyers.
They said it was impossible.
They said it was impossible, but one.
It's written in crayon. There's no way to get out of that. If only you hadn't used crayon.
But the
podcast is going to carry on. There may be a short break.
I dare say.
While I get things together.
Yeah.
I've got an idea for a YouTube channel as well.
Oh, thing to do on there.
I know.
Over the world now.
It's just I'm not sure I have time to do anything. Time is the one thing I don't have much left on.
It's not you in a shower.
No, it's not me.
No. Please don't release.
It's the 100 greatest shower scenes in movies that contain only men. Because I'm not.
No, you don't want to go there.
I'm not stodgy.
You're not going to do this Me Too thing.
No. It's just...
just him.
Male and Wookiee shower scenes only.
Oh, dear. Yes, it's...
So next week?
Next week?
I don't know what I'll be doing. I ain't got a clue.
See, you had them all lined up.
I did, but then someone said I don't want to do any anymore.
Yeah,
and now, you know... And now I think, oh, the Love Boat can come back.
Yeah, you can do the Love Boat. You can do the Love Boat.
Because I can write into the contract that I have to. They don't get a veto vote anymore.
No.
That's gone.
No. Maybe Moose. Good old Moosey.
Oh, Moosey's coming on board.
See? Moose is in the house.
Moose is in the house.
I don't know whether that was a moose
when
or what.
When Paul lets you down, you call a moose.
Yeah, that's exactly.
And Kevin's coming on board as well, so to help me, because obviously doing it weekly is quite time consuming.
I can imagine.
I think
I did about three in a row at one point.
So I thought if I break it up between people, obviously I'm doing it every week.
Well, yeah, see, you've done all 200.
I have done all 200 and more.
And more, yeah, a couple more. You get your star friend, whatever her name was.
Oh, what a. Annette Adair.
No, that did. Him.
Oh, Andre. Annette Andre. I can't get her name.
Yeah, see? Oh, meet her once. Yeah.
Meet her once. She never called me back.
No.
Yeah.
She's still trying to lick the crayon off as well. Why does he insist on writing this in crayon?
I think when she found out that I weren't in the industry, she weren't interested anymore.
No.
Cast aside. I couldn't help promote our book enough.
No. Yeah, she thought you were. She was a way in. She could see herself being on. Help me! I'm a celebrity. Get me out of here.
I think she should look at it. She did the podcast with me. She got one more book sale out of it because I had to buy the book.
Yeah, you couldn't even get it in the library for free.
No, I couldn't. I tried.
You tried.
I really tried. And I read it. You know.
Yeah. And you don't normally put that sort of commitment in.
No, and I read that book in a week. Have I ever read a book in a week? No, I haven't.
I've never known you to read a pack. You couldn't read that.
The rhyme was a bit swollen.
Yeah. Oh, the book had pictures.
It did have pictures.
Yeah. Me and Roger.
Yeah. Me and Roger. Me and Patrick McGowan. Oh, I didn't like him.
Back to me and Roger.
She'd worked with them all.
Yeah, she has.
She has.
She had worked with them all. She wasn't in Star Wars.
Yeah.
Unless she played them.
Did you want a book about her? I've got
no.
a book about
her. No.
you don't want the... It was going to be your Christmas present.
So it probably was.
But then one of the pages is quite, what's it stained? So I couldn't give that to you.
You say it's what's it stained. That's suspiciously Chewie colour. That's Wookiee.
Chewbacca.
Yeah, Wookiee colour.
They were definitely Wotsits. Well, not Wotsits, they were a cheap brand of Wotsits.
Oh, Wotsits.
Wotsits.
I was going to say, it's gone there. Yeah, I was going to have a moment of inspiration, but that went.
That's like normal then. It hasn't changed at the end, has it?
No, that went as well.
Obviously, I won't see you again now. That's it.
No, that's it. No, that's it. Done. Friendship's gone.
It's done.
No,
done. Done now. I've deleted your number from my phone already, even before you got in here. So I might say hello to your wife occasionally.
Oh, well, yeah, that's fair. Well, please pass on my condolences to her. Yeah, she's not happy I'm staying at home.
Yeah, I bet she
is. Yeah, that's why she said, you go get a cinema, you go there.
I think it's unlimited card now.
I'll pay.
See, as many movies as you want, as long as you want.
Yeah.
You know, I couldn't book Star Wars twice with my unlimited card.
Yes, you said this.
It only let me do it the once.
But this is, I thought you was taking this point up of unlimited means unlimited.
It doesn't mean quite limited.
But apparently it did.
Limited means limited. Unlimited means the opposite of limited, which is...
But you was allowed to book it up once you saw it the first time?
Once I'd been and gone and saw it, then I could book it again. But I couldn't keep two showings of it.
You can never keep two?
No, of the same film.
But you can of any other film?
Probably.
And not Star Wars.
I've never tried.
Oh, well, maybe. Fair enough.
So New Year's Day, I was in there watching Jojo Rabbit.
Oh, you've seen that, have you?
I've seen that, yeah.
Is it good?
It is good.
Yeah.
I think it's good. A lot of people saying, oh, it's tone's all wrong, but it's not really. I don't know.
Yeah,
one critic I saw completely missed the point of it, which is quite funny.
Okay.
To see, listen to every review and think, oh, you've missed this big time.
Right.
But yeah, I enjoyed it. I thought it was good. It's funny and sad, you know.
Yeah.
And because I went to the cinema by myself, and I thought, well, no one else is going to be interested in this film, so I'll just sit in the middle.
Yeah.
You know? But then two people sat either side of me and sort of boxed me in. And so when I started to cry, I just sort of wiped away a manly tear.
God, it's got hot in here.
Yeah.
It's the ceiling dripping.
Oh, dear. Where's that water coming from?
Yes, that reminds me of when I saw the Endgame Avengers and the guy next to me was crying.
No, I don't.
And you're like, what? What are you doing?
I thought I told you I took my two younger sons to see Endgame, and I was because I'd already seen the midnight showing, so I had the tissues ready, waiting for my two boys to my start. They were obviously upset at a certain point, you know. When,
yeah. Well, I think that film's gone. So we give away Star Wars. Yeah, I'm not about that one.
Yeah. So when Tony dies, they were obviously upset, but they weren't crying. I thought, oh, they had. But the guy next to me started blabbering, and I thought, should I offer him the tissues? What would you do?
It's sad. Yeah.
I mean, he weren't hiding it very well at all. There was actual noises coming out of him of blabbering as well, and I thought,
what?
Well, at least when I cry, I cry in silent, manly name.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Just a silent teardrop.
But I should point out, I cry everything. Undercover boss.
Undercover boss.
Yorkshire vet. Yeah. It doesn't matter what it is.
You're in touch with your feminine side.
So, yeah.
And you've been told about that.
Well, yeah.
Been warned.
It's the only one I can touch legally.
Yes, it was bad. I saw Little Women.
And they're tiny.
They are tiny. Well, I'm not sure if that's near
or far. Was
you
not in the big screen version?
Funny enough, no. I think it was the smallest screen possible.
Oh, yeah. There is a couple of really tiny screens over there.
Yeah, I think number 11 I might have been.
I think there's one screen, if I stretch out my arms, I can touch either side of the walls.
Yeah, I think I might have been in that one. There's only one I've never been in yet. I can't remember what it is. It's on the list.
Secret one.
Yeah, it's on the list to go see.
I think I've done them all now. All the screens, I'm 17.
One I haven't. Yeah.
There's some weird ones, because I had an unlimited viewing of one film. I think it was Ferrari versus Ford or whatever.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The other ones. And they booked it up to a bigger screen. I thought, oh, it must be really busy then. No. There's only five of us in there.
Okay.
But,
yeah. It's... Well, I don't know. I don't know what I'll do with my free time.
You'll be trawling YouTube to watch pilots, all just for entertainment's sake alone.
No.
The list I had lined up.
Yeah, I know, you frightened me with the list you had lined up. Love Boat, to start with.
No, I had a different list of just quality, top programmes that would have changed your life. Changed it for the better.
You saved it from the other previous 200.
Yeah, of course. Because you had a contract you had to do there. Yeah,
you trawled me through those, of 10 of which I'd go, yeah, they were good.
And none of which you followed up and watched a second episode.
No.
Cat's back.
Yeah, Cat's back. Well, only Batman, but never watched it straight away. Oh, and
The Secret of Isis. You were in there. You were in love with that show, no. Weren't you? No.
No. I've fewer I can remember of anything. Thunderbirds.
Yeah, we did a Gerry Anderson special, yeah, didn't we?
I love Thunderbirds, so that's
fair. We never got to do the Secret Service, did we?
Did we not do it?
I can't remember, dude. So, you missed out.
I don't know.
I can't remember if we did or didn't now.
You brought the DVD.
I brought the DVD, yeah.
I thought we did.
Well, I'm pretty sure we didn't.
No, I don't think we did, no.
See, now you want to finish on 201 now, don't you?
No.
You're out.
I'm out.
Just as I'm out, they pull me back in.
Do you think we've rambled on enough?
Yeah, enjoy your freedom. But no. I'll stay doing all the work.
Free at last.
Like normal. Yes. In fact, my job load will probably get easier now.
Yeah,
because of all the bad stuff you say, I don't have to edit out anymore.
No.
I don't know what you've got against Eskimos, but it was a lot. You've said a lot about them over the years.
Have I?
Yeah. And I just had to edit it all out. I said, I don't want them on my back. They've got harpoons.
No, well. I've had a go at most people.
Yes. Yes, you have. I've got the outtakes. Yeah, you definitely have. No one was safe.
No.
But
least of all Moose.
Poor Moose.
Actually, I've had to go at him several times.
Yes, he knows.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
I forwarded your address.
No, it's all right. He's fine. He can have a go back. I never listen to him, so it don't matter.
He's a big guy.
Yeah, so it's in the pictures.
It is in the pictures. In the pictures he sent me. Yeah. But I'll tell you what
he's not a big guy, he's just a Wookiee with a shave.
Yeah, you can see it, get it all out now, yeah, can't you?
You can keep that one in, I don't care. You're just a big hairy Wookiee.
And what about a poor bloke who was tunneling out?
He's brilliant. He's still going.
He's still going.
He's come back in.
Several times.
He's filled the hole back in. He's come back in. Don't let me out there. They're nuts.
That was a running joke that went nowhere.
I didn't know where to go with it.
In a straight line.
He came back.
But you're going to want this for a ringtone or a message.
Oh, woman.
You're going to listen to what
you said
there.
It, sir.
Yeah, true. Probably do listen to that a lot. But
of course, you'll still be here in some...
Ryan's brilliant.
Yeah. In some key ways.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, trust me, my phone never says that.
But now, apparently, you are...
He's dead.
He's dead, Chuck.
Dead.
The man is dead.
He's dead.
He's dead.
He's dead, sir.
He's dead, Chuck.
To me. But you'll lose your theme tune as well. But it's true now.
Yes.
You won't let me down again.
No, I'll never let you down again.
Because you're gone.
You can't play that now. You can't have that. You can't have that now.
But we need to go out on a big number, don't we?
What?
So I'm thinking we needed...
Where's the kaboom?
Oh.
There was supposed to be an earth-shattering kaboom.
But,
where else have you gone there?
Well, I have the classic.
Oh, you still got that?
Many things have come and gone. That's staying.
Married is staying.
And, of course, I used to call you sometimes...
I call that bold talk for a one-eyed fat man.
You did?
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah, you were very offended.
No.
And of course, I had the alternative to the...
Oh, yeah.
She's a woman, sir.
Woman, sir.
No, I mean, she's a woman. She's a... She's a woman, sir. She's clearly a woman, right? With all due respect.
I'm not sure that would apply to the woman, sir.
No, I wasn't. No, well... Played by man.
Yeah. And that's it, and you're out.
I'm out. That's it. I'm gone. Bye-bye.
Thank God.